Hey, what's up, guys? It's Matt with Movement System. In this video, we're going to talk about the blood flow through the heart. We're going to talk about all of the important valves, the important chambers, the important things to know, and terminology here. Let's go ahead and dive into it. All right, so let's start off here talking about the atria and the ventricles. So this right here is the heart. It's represented as the four chambers. Technically, this one's a little bit bigger. The ventricles in general are bigger, but we just broke these up into quadrants to keep it simple. All right, so starting up here, we have the atria. They're smaller. And when we have the heart going lub-dub, the lub is going to be the atria contracting, and then the dub is the ventricles contracting. So in terms of blood flow, we're going to start up here at the right atria. This is deoxygenated blood that came from the veins, and as it gets into the right atria, it's then going to be pumped down through the tricuspid valve. So tricuspid valve is three on the right side, tri, through the tricuspid valve and into the right ventricle. Now, from the right ventricle, we're going to go through the pulmonary valve. The pulmonary valve is one of the semilunar valves, and this is going to go to the pulmonary artery. So artery always means away from the heart. So this is the one artery that's actually deoxygenated blood. Most arteries are oxygenated, but because this is going away from the heart into the lungs, it's an artery, it's the pulmonary artery, but it's carrying deoxygenated blood. So through the pulmonary valve, through the pulmonary artery, to the lungs, there's going to be gas exchange through the alveoli into the capillaries here. And then we're going to go into the pulmonary vein. The pulmonary vein, vein meaning towards the heart, is going to be now oxygenated blood coming back to the left atrium. And now the left atrium is going to be connected to the left ventricle. So blood's flowing from the left atria through the bicuspid valve, which is also known as the mitral valve. And that's on the left side of the heart. And that's going to be going into the left ventricle. So what you guys can probably notice here is that the right side of the paper is actually left. But we're imagining this heart as if you're looking at someone. So this is how the heart would look like if you were viewing my heart from here, left side of my body is the right side of your view. All right, now we're in the left ventricle. She's thick, big. This is the biggest, thickest chamber over here, the left ventricle. And it's gonna get pumping blood out into the aorta. The aorta, big and thick as well, is our biggest artery. And how are we gonna get from the left ventricle to the aorta? Through the aortic valve. So aortic valve is just going to the aorta. And again, the left ventricle is the biggest chamber. It's pushing blood out. As it contracts, it's going to cause that systolic blood pressure to go up and push that blood out into the aorta. And then just to make the connection here, it's going to go down through the arteries, through the arterioles, through the capillaries, up through the venules, the veins, into the vena cava. If the blood's coming from the body, it's going to be from the inferior vena cava. Or if it's from the brain or above the neck, it's going to come from the superior vena cava back to where we started at the right atria. And just to clarify, all this blue here is deoxygenated blood. The blood was oxygenated over here in the arteries and the arterioles, but as it went to the capillaries, it gave that oxygen to the muscles, to the organs, and then as it goes to the veins, the venules, it's going to be deoxygenated over here. If this was helpful for you, make sure you go ahead and smash that like button to help other people find the video. Make sure you subscribe so you don't miss future videos, and I'll catch you guys in the next one. Thanks.